Welcome back. You're still watching Urban Today. It is Women's Day. Happy Women's to you. Those of you who have just joined us, join our conversations on social media. And today we are speaking to women in leadership. We are trying to understand Bachikola Batia. Some of us look up to them and like, hey, mama, how shall we get to that? How can I even balance? How do I, for example, leave my house clean and then I have to go to office and then I'm thinking, hey, did I make my bed? You know, those small things that actually make a whole big difference. Now, I'm speaking to Lieutenant Colonel Edith Nakalema. She is the head of the anti-corruption state house, and she's here trying to, you know, paint a picture. Every time I look at something, I think she has like somebody who organizes her wardrobe. Then maybe she does, another one is painting her nails. She's always looking beautiful, and she's told us that. Plan your life, have something, know when to do what, when, where, those things. So I'm speaking to her, and it's such a very wonderful conversation. Now, Lieutenant Colonel, before we went for the break, I did mention and actually asked, when you began your career, did you ever imagine that you could be a leader in, for example, no, not just for example, in a male-dominated, you know, profession?
Not at all. I need to remind you, my daughter Lynn, that also many people admire you, including myself, when I also see you on TV looking beautiful, and I'm like, this young lady, how does she make it? Because for me, I don't think I can also be on the screen every morning and smiling and looking good and talking this calm and convincing language. So you're also admired. I also admire you a lot.
That's so sweet. That's
yes,
so sweet.
Because I am not gifted in that line of yours, and so thank God that you also have a platform. You're convincing. You're beautiful. You're wonderful, and happy Women's Day.
Thank you.
So your question: when I was growing up, did I ever imagine I would? Not at all. Like I told you, for me, I always wanted to make a contribution and be different.
Yes. Stand out is
yes,
the word.
Yes. My father and mother, my parents, are in the lowest level of the Church of Uganda service. My father has been a lay reader for the last, I think, 51 years. I was born and I found him a lay reader, and he's still happily giving his service at that low level. And so I am giving you that example to show you that I was brought up in a, should I call it a peasantry home, where the five of us, the children, with our father and mother, were always in our home, very happy with our Bible and hymn book, singing every evening, looking at each other indeed as siblings, and we have our father, our mother, grandfather, grandmother, a huge family, but this nucleus family of ours, we were always looking ahead of God's service. We wanted to serve God in different ways. So for me, I never thought of competing with anyone, but I was always praying and wishing that I make a contribution wherever God will take me. So I didn't go to very good schools, again, because my father and mother could not manage school fees of the big schools or the well-known schools.
Okay.
But in the schools I went to, and this is Rutoma Secondary School, Chibura Girls, and then later I joined UCC Kabare. Then I graduated when it was already MUBS. Then I later did my first degree at Nkumba when I started work. So I was not looking at working with men or at the top. No. While I was in school, I was always reading hard, and I thank God that I used to perform well in those schools where I went to. I was always among the good performing students. Then I also became a leader in school. I was always a chairperson, Scripture Union,
Okay.
But I also became a deputy head girl in Orevo. Mm-hmm. Then HSC or high school.
Yeah, yeah.
I was a deputy chairperson of the school council, mm-hmm. but also leading the fellowship. So, and when I was also at college, I headed the school. It was called Christian Union. Yes. So I was always in the leadership of the church because I was always
because of the background.
Wanting to serve God, because and my faith still is that you have faith and trust in God, and work hard, and all the rest will follow. Because once you work hard, surely
actually
now, working hard pays.
Now that you mentioned that, I wanted to ask you, what is your secret? What is that secret to success? What is that, Kawan, you keep to yourself? Maybe today
it is not much. Mm-hmm. One thing I do every morning, I get up and say, thank you, God, for this new morning. I want to make a contribution to my country. I want to be an example to my children and to those that maybe look to me. Mm. I always want to give my best. So the secret remains having faith, trusting God, and working hard. That is the only secret.
Have faith,
Trust
faith, in God.
Trust in God and work hard.
Work hard.
And surely God pays. Mm. You know, the Bible says in Deuteronomy chapter 28, mm-hmm. And the title of that chapter is The Blessings of the Obedient.
Yes.
So you also have to be obedient to your leaders. Mm-hmm. You have to be loyal to your leaders if you want to succeed. So the basic principle in my life is having faith, trusting God, mm-hmm. working hard, in obedience and loyalty to my God. Leaders.
Yes, and the
And I also want to always have people who follow my example without telling them. I want to work and people see so they can follow. Mm. I believe in results. I am a result-oriented person. I really don't like having time to speak about the work I do or what I have done. I want people to see and talk. And I have also learned to never be discouraged by criticism. And I would appeal to my sisters and daughters never to give up, never to fear criticism. Actually, learn from every failure in life. When you fail, don't give up. Know that that is an opportunity for you to improve.
Absolutely.
Know that that is an opportunity for you to try again and even make yourself or other people's lives better. Mm. Mm. So for me, it was not about where would I work, will I ever make it? No, it was about having contribution, positive contribution to wherever
you're posted.
Yes, to wherever I will pass. I want to leave a clean and good trail. Mm. When I have finally served and maybe retired and finally gone to my home above.
Okay. You see, I've interacted with many women, and most of them, they tell you you have to kind of fight your way to the top. You kind of have to step on certain heads or shoulders or somehow most of them slip their way to the top. We've had that.
Yes.
But what has been your biggest barrier? Let's talk about that. What has been your biggest barrier in your career?
Lynn, I don't remember any barrier, but like I said, work is always challenging. But to me, I always believe in overcoming challenges. Mm-hmm. Again, because of my Christian background, I know that there is nothing impossible when you trust in God and work hard. So I have not looked for any appointment in my life since I started work. I am always working hard and promotions have come. Like you may be having my background by now because we have interacted maybe for some time. Mm. When I joined the army and how I joined it was a call from God, because we were recruited in 1998 we were the first group that His Excellency the President got through church leaders after our should I say tertiary institutions, because we are from colleges and universities, and we were got from all regions of Uganda, if not districts. And when we reached in the train, meanwhile we were recruited to work in the Revenue Protection Services, to work as Revenue Protection Officers,
okay,
SRPS. But while we were in training, I personally realized that I had already turned into a soldier. I was not going to be a civilian again, because our training took long. Given that we were the first group, maybe who I can call the elite in the army.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, others had been there, but we are the biggest group, over 300 people that were recruited from all over Uganda. We would ask questions, and then, of course, our instructors would say, the Kiswahili word, our bado iva, like we're not yet ready.
Uh-huh.
So our training, which was supposed to take 6 months, ended up taking 11 months.
Oh.
Yes. So we really became soldiers. To me, I was like, do I still have to go back and claim that I'm a civilian? Anyhow, I also had a dream while there,
uh-huh,
that I was to carry a gun and walk a long journey. I can't explain the whole dream, but in my journey, in the dream, I saw myself in full uniform, carrying a gun, walking through wolves, but finally I entered a huge golden house,
wow,
which I had never seen in the physical. So to me, being a Christian, I said, okay, I am meant to serve my country in full uniform.
Mm-hmm.
I will be a soldier.
Wow.
So whereas I was on the list, and in among the very first on the list to go to Uganda Revenue Authority on our pass out, I walked to the friend who was reading the list, and I said, my brother, I choose to go and do cadet. Because we are given an opportunity that those who will not go to Revenue Authority, please go straight to, that time it was still called Gaddafi Barracks,
okay,
Jinja, for cadet.
Mm-hmm.
And the president himself came and briefed us on that and asked us, when we were still many, he said he would want us to be the ones to join and to start professionalizing the army,
okay,
because indeed we are from different professions.
Mm.
We had different professions. And so I chose to leave the opportunity of working in the Revenue Authority. Remember that time, now this was 1999, the women or girls who would join army at that time were looked at as maybe social unfit. That time, sure. Because lately, UPDF is a highly respected institution, I believe.
Yes, yes.
Because nearly the whole force went to school, but early late 90s, those who went to school are not very many, and their women were also not many.
Mm.
So for me to have come from a Christian family, I was always leading Christian fellowships, and so choosing to go to the army, to join the army, was not an easy decision for me, given that I was thinking about
the
how
stereotype.
My parents will take it.
Yes.
Then the chaperones, all those I went to school with.
Yeah.
But I was very convinced that I was going to remain a born-again Christian. I was going to go through training,
mm-hmm,
not because of looking for any favor from any man.
Mm-hmm.
I believed in hard work. I believed in trusting God for everything.
Absolutely.
So I was very confident that I was going to succeed in the military career.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow. What a very interesting one there. You actually talk about your dream of walking through wolves, and The girls of this generation call the men around us wolves. Yeah.
Really?
Of course, there are those who are not well-mannered, and they're the ones they've you know, called wolves. Now, this brings me to the question of, do you experience resistance when you are, for example, trying to lead men in any way, and in this, your capacity? Have you found any resistance from the men especially? Like, but we can do this. Why would they choose a woman?
Lynn, that I don't read people's mind to know what is there, I must admit. Okay. The men especially, and also the women. But there is one good thing for us in the forces, security forces, and in particular, the UPDF. In the UPDF, if you have been listening, after all, you are in the media.
Yes, yes.
You will never hear that you will never hear a word woman in the UPDF.
Yes.
It is officers and men of the UPDF.
Yes,
the uniformed,
yes.
Garant, yes. Officers and
yes.
Men. Meaning that the issue of gender does not have, there are no genders in the army. What matters is your rank. What matters, because why we put rank first? For you to go through cadet training, you have already proved to be a man, an officer. I mean, there is nothing like you are a woman or man.
No,
you are an officer.
Absolutely.
You qualify for a deployment at your rank, or also given the courses that you have done. So for me, it hasn't been very hard to approach men. I haven't felt or I haven't seen any man coming to me to say, why are you here? Because to me, the question is, it answers itself directly.
Mm-hmm.
I am wherever I am because I was trusted to be there. I was appointed by the appointing authority. So you can't question why I am there.
Absolutely.
And not you. Mm-hmm. Maybe you...
Maybe they give you
qualify.
The bad eye. Maybe when you're passing, like, ah, that woman is here, you know?
I believe that those who would say that are those that know that I will not tolerate any kind of laziness. Whether you are a man or a woman, you must do your work if you are under my leadership.
Yes.
And so I don't look at men or women.
Mm.
I look at the officers or the officials that I work with.
Mm-hmm.
And so when I am addressing ladies and
gentlemen. Yes.
I am addressing officers and men of the UPDF.
Okay.
I am addressing the police officers.
Mm-hmm.
But importantly, I am saying you must take a direction that I am led to.
Right.
So I don't find any obstacle in my work because I remain in my line of duty and I don't have any fear in myself that maybe here I am...
Maybe what is that man thinking?
No,
you know?
No.
Okay.
God
okay.
did me a favor. I have a gentleman who I have to respect. That one is my husband at home.
Mm-hmm.
But also I pay due respect to all my seniors.
Absolutely.
And also I ensure that the officers under me are shown the right way by living an exemplary life in action, in maybe also in speech.
Mm.
I try to tell them what they have to do if they are to work with me.
Absolutely.
So I never look at who is taking me how. No,
that it one. Doesn't matter.
That question is never in my mind.
That's a very good one. That's a very good one.
That question is never in my mind. Who is looking at me how? No, the one who...
That's a very good. From today,
the
I have
one
learned
who
that.
Wanted to who could have looked at maybe my physique and what and took me home is there.
He's
and
there.
We are working. So the others, how they look at me?
We're sorted. Sort yourselves. I am sorted from today.
Yes.
Thank you for teaching me that.
Honestly, I never think about who is looking at me. How no, I pay due respect to the people.
Absolutely.
That deserve the respect. I also address the ones that are not doing their work the way I must, mm-hmm. and remember, I'm a soldier, so begging is not part of me.
No. That's a very, I've learned something very huge. Now, as we wind up, Lieutenant Colonel, what advice do you leave for the girls that look up to you, the ones who want to, who look up to you and be like, wow, I want to be able to pull off something like that?
The main advice to my young daughters and sisters, maybe and mothers, the main advice remains that please have faith and trust in God first. It is important. And next, never underlook yourself. Mm-hmm. Always know that you have special competencies in yourself that another person doesn't have, because we are all created differently and we can all do something different. We can all contribute to our societies. Mm-hmm. We can all be better people.
Absolutely.
So I want to advise and appeal to our dear mothers, to my sisters, to my daughters, that please trust in God, have faith in God, and work hard. Please, wherever you will be, always work hard. Trust in God and work hard and be obedient. Be loyal. Never give in to the men that want to pull you down or to look down upon you. No, you have a special skill. You have special competencies. You have many gifts. Believe in yourself.
Absolutely.
That is key. Ladies, let us believe in ourselves. We can make it. When I found myself working for the president and being given an opportunity, I have great exposure. I've been to the nearly to all continents, apart from Australia. So I am grateful to God that He lifted me from the lowest level and gave me a chance to serve in the highest office of the land. And I have also made friends from across the globe. When I went for my senior staff,
we call it senior staff college, but in the UK it is advanced command and staff course. At the Defence Academy, I was able to interact with students from over 80 countries.
Wow.
And I made friends.
Wow.
So you can make it when you remain focused, when you work hard, when you trust in God, and have faith.
Absolutely.
But importantly, keep your homes in order. Then you will perform better wherever you are deployed.
Wow. That's very, very key. Very key. Don't leave home when your house is shabby and your husband is annoyed and your children are not happy. Make sure everything is in order. Your work will be in order as well. Now, thank you very much, Lieutenant Colonel Edith Nakalema, for gracing our studio and for making time to encourage us, the women that look up to you.
Thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to share my views with maybe the ladies, but also our great and valued fathers, our husbands, our sons.
Yes.
It's been a great opportunity. And I want to say happy Women's Day, our mothers, sisters, and daughters. But also, thank you, our great men, our fathers, our brothers, and sons. Thank you for supporting us. We are grateful to you. And on behalf of other women who may not have gotten a chance to speak, to a chance to appear and maybe be listened to or be watched, I want to appreciate our men, and I want to encourage the ladies to move on courageously. We are able to make great exploits.
Absolutely.
I thank you.
Fantastic. I have learned that, Bambi, your thoughts, keep your thoughts to yourself. As long as I'm doing my job, do your job. I will walk in this lane. Please, stay focused. Hey, you're joking with me today on Women's Day. Anyway, I want to end on a note. Strong women are not simply born. They are nurtured, they are inspired, and they know other strong women. May we be those kinds of women. Happy Women's Day to you and yours, to my mother, to my sisters, to my cousins, to everybody, to all the women. But most importantly, like the Colonel has said, the men, thank you for noticing us, for appreciating us, and for knowing that we are women. We have roles we play, you have roles you play. So thank you for appreciating. On that note, happy Women's Day to you. We end the show here. We'll definitely catch you again tomorrow. God bless you.